Football, a great sport. I'm from Texas. I live in Texas, and it's part of the culture, and it's part of the spirit of the fall and school starting, and it's an enjoyable experience for a lot of families, and so we are part of that culture. So one of the things we have to think about, though, is what is actually happening to the children or the young adults that are actually playing football and they grow older and maybe go to college or even play professional. You got to understand that in football, there's multiple collisions of your head to somebody else's head or body parts or the ground. And what happens is the brain is now sort of like a gelatinous piece of material that's in a bony vault of your skull. So even when you have a helmet on and even when you have the best gear, your brain is still jostling around within that, and it can cause it to shear or to rotate or to bounce back and forth, and that can either bruise it or alter its function. Some people can come off the sidelines or to the sidelines and they end up having a lot of symptoms that's very, very easy to see, so a trainer or a coach can say, hey, you're out. But some people have very, very small amounts of trauma and it accumulates over time and the symptoms are not that drastic or not that big, so they're allowed to play over and over and over, and their repetitive trauma sets them up for having disastrous results down the road, and that could be 5, 10, or even 20 years later. So what we advocate is a few things, and that is prevention. Learn how to tackle appropriately, learn how to play the game the right way, and learn how to use your overall body when you're following and when you're tackling people. The second thing I would say is this: there needs to be good baseline testing so that if you get injured, you can now compare yourself after the injury to the way you were before the injury. The other thing I would say is this: if you've had a concussion, you need to have an adequate amount of time to rest. Typically 1 to 2 days is not it. Sometimes it may take 1, 2, or even 3 weeks, even when you're asymptomatic. There's all kinds of things you can do between nutrition and food and knowing what your weaknesses are genetically. And there's lots of things that you can know that we understand from a clinical point of view. But this year when you're playing football, know a few tips and know a few things so that when you get older, you can do your job appropriately, you can think, you can have relationships, you don't have emotional volatility, you don't have insomnia, you don't have brain fog, or all these other things that go into a post-concussive patient just because you played some football when you were younger.